Welcome to this episode of Gonzo Gamer. This is the Battle of Distress Call, using the JMP mod, Ultimate General Civil War, Major General Difficulty, Union Campaign. Taking a look at our AI scaling, you can see how it affects this battle. With it set at 1.3, we're looking at 18,444 soldiers and 54 guns for the Confederacy. Now, had we left AI scaling at the base of 1, we would have been facing about 14,397 and 42 guns. Now, I've played Distress Call with scaling as high as 1.6. The primary issue you run into is managing all the enemy charges. There are multiple considerations used by the AI to determine its actions. But generally speaking, the greater the numerical advantage is for the AI, the more likely it is to charge. So the more you increase the scaling, the more charges you get here, since both the Union and the Confederate forces are all deployed early in the battle. As I stated in my previous video, the deployment screen for Distress Call is incorrect. You can actually deploy 12 units here. However, the only way to do that is to have an AO of 4, which means you must have taken both AO selections during the campaign setup, which also happened to be the 2 training selections, and then used your 2 career points from Philippi on AO also. Pantakraut said that this will be corrected in the next mod, but I don't know if the correction will be for displaying 12 brigades on the next deploy screen, or if they'll be enforcing taking only 10 brigades. Obviously, there are a number of ways to approach this battle. If I had not increased scaling, then I told the North Depot and engage the enemy coming in from the north. The North Depot actually gives you some pretty decent cover bonuses that the South Depot does not, even though they look identical. With scaling turned up here, I prefer to hold the South Depot and move a group of forces to intercept the Confederate units that are going to be coming across the bridge to the east. We got a split on one of the Allied units, which is always nice. I would have loved graded cav to bring to this battle, but in this battle you get a bunch of 1859 carbines after the battle, since the Allied cav and skirmishers both carry them. So I can make cavalry after this battle without having to buy any weapons. So it's much cheaper to wait and create them at the next camp before you go to First Bull Run. It's pretty common for the Confederacy units coming across the bridge to have some duplicates. It looks like we have 1 infantry and 1 artillery have rolled splits here. and the ammo wagon that comes across with them may cross the bridge to the south, or it may turn and go to the north. We'll have to wait and see what it does. If I was defending the North Depot, I would have taken my Napoleon artillery at the beginning of the battle. That way, what they would have already been in position to start firing. But since we're defending the South, I've let them all my artillery come in with the rest of my units. One issue that I run into on the right side is being flanked from the rear by enemy cav, so I like to get at least one, if not two, units to defend against that. I do not understand why this two-star unit is routing through my line rather than going back to their own. I actually thought that that wasn't possible any longer, but you still see it sometimes. the enemy KF came here to get their supply wagon back, and my KF are no longer here, so we'll have to see what we can do about that. The left side is getting under control now, but some of my units need some rest as soon as they get a chance. It hasn't occurred yet, but eventually everyone experiences ghost cav at some point playing this game, and I absolutely refuse to just sit there and let the game keep running when ghost cav appears. Bad things happen when you do that, so I always handle it the same way. Regardless of when it happens and where it happens, when I realize that ghost cav is going on, I will immediately save the game and then immediately reload the game save. That will reset the sprites to appear in the actual location. Unfortunately, it also resets your units back to their defaults and resets the charge cooldown timer as if the battle had just started. So if you told your cav or skirmishers not to hit and run and to hold their position, or you've told your supply wagons to only outfit small arms, then you'll have to go back and reset all those. So we lost about 19% of our forces, and the AI lost about 68% of theirs. Most of our brigade officers were promoted. The two wounded officers were both Allied officers. And there's the carbines that we want for creating our cav before we go to First Bull Run. So we will see you at First Bull Run, and thanks for watching.